Wild Boy by James Lincoln Collier. Narrated by Kirby Heyborne. Chapter 1. There was a place where a rock outcropping stuck out of the side of the mountain. Nothing grew there, and you could see for miles across the prairie down below. I don't know how many miles, 20, 50, maybe 100 for all I knew. You could see the river wandering through the grass like a brown snake wriggling across the prairie, and beside it, the little town where I come from, and not much else. Lazy clouds slipping across the blue sky, a few clumps of trees here and there by a sinkhole where there was water. Not much else. The town was maybe 10 miles away. I knew, because I walked it more than once. But sometimes there'd be people down there, maybe a wagon train of overlanders heading for Oregon, maybe a couple of fellas riding off somewheres, maybe a few Indians racing through the prairie grass on their ponies. I liked going there when I felt lonely, just lie on the warm rock with the sun on my back and see what was going on. Sometimes I'd lie there for the longest time, watching a wagon train wind along the river, churning up a cloud of yellow-brown dust that rose up and up into the sky until the wagon train disappeared in the north and I couldn't see it no more. I was low in mind right then, hadn't been able to scare up hardly anything serious to eat for 3 days. Some wild strawberries I come on in a little clearing, and a fair-sized turtle that was laying on a rock in the sun. Turtles don't have no sense. The strawberries wasn't quite right, but I ate 'em anyway. The turtle was pretty good, but there was blame little to him. I was still mighty hungry as I lay on the warm outcropping, pressing my belly on the rock so as to make it seem less empty. There wasn't much to see this time, just a couple of fellas loping along on their horses. One of them had a buck slung over the rump of his horse. I figured they must have come up to the mountain hunting to have some fun for themselves and was heading back to town to cook up a venison steak. I wondered, was they old pals that liked doing things among themselves? Was one of them a newcomer out here, and this other fella took him out hunting to be friendly? I always liked making up ideas about people I seen down on the prairie. Was they this or that? Still, I wasn't about to go back down there and say hello to them. As far as I was concerned, them people could have the town, the prairie, and all of that. I had enough of people to suit me for a while. They wasn't no damn good. I couldn't go back there anyways, for what I did to Pa. But even if I couldn't, I wouldn't have. But oh my, I was hungry. Still, I was up in the mountains where I always wanted to be, and I was bound and determined I was going to stay there. Them mountain men come into our store from time to time for stuff, powder and shot, new knife when they lost the old one, pants, flour, shoes. Generally, they come down every 2 or 3 months when they have a load of fur to take to the trading post a ways down the river from the town. Pack the skins down out of the mountains on their back, and pack a load of stuff from the store back up into the mountains. Oh, they was something to look at. Hair down over their ears, beards all scraggly where they hacked at them with the skinning knife, clothes torn and patched. They looked so hard and fierce, game for anything and wouldn't take nothing from nobody, I couldn't get my eyes off them. Then they'd go around to the barber for a shave and a haircut, and when they come back, you wouldn't recognize it was the same fella. They'd pick out some new clothes off Pa's shelves, go out into the backyard to change, and give Pa their old clothes to burn. Then, like as not, they'd sit around the store on a barrel and tell stories about fighting a bear with a skinning knife, about getting lost in a snowstorm and only saved themselves by falling into a cave by mistake, about dancing with the Indians and having the Indian girls fall in love with them. Oh, I admired them so. Wasn't nothing I ever wanted to be more than a mountain man. But it wasn't all glory. I only been up there 2, 3 weeks, and I found that out already. You went hungry a lot of times, cold and wet if you got caught out in a rainstorm 2 miles from home.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.